We are the paradoxical ape. Bipedal, naked, large-brained, long the master of fire, tools, and language, but still trying to understand ourselves. Aware that death is inevitable, yet filled with optimism. We grow up slowly. We hand down knowledge. We empathize and deceive. We shape the future from our shared understanding of the past. CARTA brings together experts from diverse disciplines to exchange insights on who we are and how we got here. An exploration made possible by the generosity of humans like you.
I'm delighted to be here. Even 20 years ago, if someone asked you to imagine or to think about human evolution, you would think fossils. Maybe you would think about bones. Rarely would you ever think about skin. So it's no wonder that in this grand question that Ajit posed, that skin received very short shrift. Skin, after all, is rarely preserved for more than a few thousand years. So we have no or very little physical evidence of it. So because anthropologists and human biologists like hard evidence, physical hard evidence that they can examine, skin for years, if it was studied at all, was studied from the perspective of comparative anatomy, including histology, some physiology, some a little bit of genetics. But things have changed dramatically. And in the last 20 years, skin has been studied from a variety of perspectives. And in fact, the whole field of human evolution is now studied from a variety of perspectives, not just fossil evidence and a little bit of comparative anatomy, but comparative and functional genomics, evolutionary developmental biology, studies of the microbiome, and myriad others. We can bring so many lines of evidence to bear. And that's what we're going to do today. What was almost a complete mystery 20 or 25 years ago, or something about which we knew very little, we now know much more about. Today, we have assembled a series of scholars, and many of them don't even self-identify as evolutionary biologists, but they're doing work that is highly pertinent to human evolutionary biology. And we've brought them together because they're doing exciting and important work related to this largest organ of our bodies that is more different than any other organ system that we have compared to that of our closest relatives, chimpanzees. What an exciting day. We're going to be sharing in the work of some of human evolution's best detectives. So with that brief and I hope intriguing introduction, I want to introduce our first speaker, Richard Gallo, who will start us off in this marvelous journey of discovery into the unique aspects of human skin. I'm tremendously grateful to Ajit Varki, Pascal Gagneux, and all of the CARTA organizers and sponsors for making this, which I hope will be a wonderful event, possible.